Yeah. Sunshine 24 hours a day.
Solar system.
have some music this time. First of all, this star, where's this star Sirius? Let's find Sirius. Stars in the series. Thank you. back to the solar system. Video. Sirius is right here. Sirius the sun. And this is what the suns are doing. They rotate. And our sun rotates and over also. Sun is moving this way, and Sirius is moving our way. Now, what's going to happen is our sun is traveling this way. Stay circling around each other right here with the power of our thoughts. Power of thought. We're going to cause these two suns to circle around each other. Now, here's the Earth right here. The Earth and the Moon are right here. Of course, the Earth travels counterclockwise around the Sun. Like that. So, so all we have to do is just realize that we're in the center right here. These two suns are going to move around each other like this. And everything's going to as they continue certainly spinning like a top, just like a top, except they'll be moving through space this way. Pop-up that happened to Now, the idea that I have, the power of thought, is while these two suns are circling right here, what we're going to do is we're going to bring in, let's just suspend the suns and add. Oh, that's what it would be. Okay. So these suns would be still. Just like this sun right here is still. These two suns would be still just like that. But they will be moving in this direction down here. Both suns would be moving this way. So my idea, or our idea is this, is to bring in another sun right here. Sun right here. Bring in another sun right here. Bring in another sun right here. So actually, we would have these suns equal distance around. This right here would be the Earth, and as the Earth traveled around the main sun, it would have light 24 hours a day, all the way around. See what I'm saying? And if we could make this three-dimensional, then we'd also put suns at the bottom of this drawing. Top. So it would be an equilibrium of light. And with the power of our thought, we could turn down the temperature of the sun so that it makes it nice and just the right temperature 24 hours a day. Probably about 75 degrees. 75 degrees is pretty decent. If we wanted to. Yeah, that's what, with the power of our thought, we can also turn these planets also into Earths. We can turn all these planets into Earths. And we could just travel from Earth to Earth. This would be a big giant Earth. That's the idea. Now, let's see if we can get that video. Let's bring it up. Fast forward.
different, or it has its own term.
Now let's enlarge so we can see what the date is. It's July 1982. Alright, so there we go. Let's go down here. Let's put the date in. This star is right there. It's highlighted. There it is. See that? It says Sirius. Now, let's enlarge this. Quick highlight. We have our eye on that star. Actually, let's just
this is the second sun that's coming into our universe.
Stop that. Okay. Here it is.
This is what the Mayan shift was all. It has to do with this star, right? Go ahead and click the screen to stop it. To stop the orbit of the spaceship. So, here we are. This one over here is Uranus. This one's Saturn. This right here. Here is the Sirius.
See it at least.
It does say Sirius on it. Alpha Como. Alpha Como, it looks like. It says Sirius.
So. And it says, 12 May 1980. There we are. Alright. Good. Let's go to 12 May stars are fixed. Last time I did this, Sirius was up here. can see Saturn as the planet with the rings around it. And it is, takes 30 years to go around the sun. So the stars are all staying fixed. Possibly they're, you have to look at this another day to see if the charts reveal Sirius again. 1990s, this would be the year of Kurt Cobain in Seattle. Saturn's made one big turn in 1990. So that would tell us that all the planets could have been in all the same positions in 30 years. said, now, last time I did study on Sirius or a video, it seems to me that they said Sirius was a cluster of seven stars already. So when Sirius arrives, it'll bring all those other stars with it. So it'll be an automatic, we'll have plenty of stars. Like, we'll be living forever, and we'll actually be living to enter into eternity here soon, much more before the planets. We can actually speed up with our thoughts these two stars, or suns, to be Sirius, and our sun, the sun of our solar system. We can bring them closer together quickly, and then have them slow down as they circle turns, and then just continue circling around each other, or be stationary, and we'll all just move all in the same direction. So here we are, 2014, there we are. Let's move back in time a little bit. There we go. Too far. Have a solar eclipse here. Look back. Start. Stop it. Here we are. Stop. Stop. Everything stopped. And let's hover on the stars again. Series shows up. Very interesting, huh? So right here in this video, Sirius is right down there. So we'll check it on another day. But everyone can see it right there on Sirius the star. And it's heading this way toward the sun. So that's that. So we have the idea. So we'll in our eternity we'll have 24 hours of sunlight all the time, nice and cold. All the snow will melt. And with our thoughts we'll evaporate the water evenly. So everything stays the same.